To print or not to print? That is the question. Specifically, a question I've been asking myself quite a lot recently. I'm Geoh, and I make models and many other things. I've been doing it for a couple of years now. I like to think of each project as a stepping stone, taking away what went wrong, but also what went right, and then applying that to future projects. I'm always trying to improve and open to trying new techniques and methods. And with that comes new equipment. And as you can guess, that brings us to 3D printing. I remember way back in 2012 while at my friend's house, I was shown a video on the most modern 3D printers at the time. I was awed by this. Imagine having access to this machine. Any specific tool, piece, or objects you'd ever need, you can just simply make yourself. Amazing! Of course, at the time, seeing the size of that machine, I could only think of how out of reach something like that would be. But hey, that was 2012. We're in the future now. 12 years later, in 2024, 3D printing is actually pretty accessible. Most schools and libraries have them available for public use, and hey, even on Amazon, with one click, you can have one delivered to your house tomorrow morning. The future evolves fast. But despite my excitement, I was slightly hesitant to slowly adopt the technology. If you've seen my videos, most of what I do is done from scratch, or at least scratch on a pre-existing base. My personal fear was that if I adopted 3D printing, I would become too reliant on the technology, eventually just allowing it to take over the creation process. Like, why would I make it when I could just print it? But I personally think that was the worst view I could have. 3D printing can only take over my work if I let it take over. I've decided instead to embrace 3D printing, essentially adding it to my arsenal of tools as a support or crutch rather than replacing them, all working in perfect harmony. With that, I finally decided to take the leap and procure a printer, specifically one that printed in PLA filament. I toyed around with the idea of resin as for its amazing details, but felt that PLA better fit my needs, especially as I'd be making more bulky pieces that needed to take a beating, and resin was a bit too fragile for my needs. After searching around, I finally settled on the Elegoo Neptune 4 Max printer, and Elegoo was kind enough to send me one to take a look at today. First thing I have to say is that it certainly lives up to the name, Max. This printer is massive, the maximum. I was genuinely shocked at how large this unit really was. The printer comes partially assembled in a box, and you have to do the rest. I found the process to be pretty smooth generally. There were a few areas that were slightly confusing and I had to backtrack on, but overall it was fine. I was shocked at not only how quickly it set up, but after basic calibration testing, it was ready to print. The printer also comes equipped with this separate touch screen to control the printer and select prints. It's honestly such a cool addition. But with it all set up, let's talk about the prints themselves and print quality. You'd probably assume that you can just throw an STL file on a USB and you're off to the races. Wrong. You need to prepare your prints on the Elegoo Cura program. You can also use slicers or other programs like Orca or Persa, but I decided to use Cura as that's what's included with the printer. The filament extruder on the printer has a nozzle on it that can print between 0.12 and 0.28 millimeters, leading to incredibly fine details on prints. So the program gives you control on how fine you want the extrusion to be, as well as adding supports or adhesion to the print. I've found adhesion to be the most helpful, as I've found some prints with flat bottoms warp without it. The supports are also pretty essential, but I've found on some pieces they can be avoided by simply changing the orientation of a print, like with this roof piece. Stemming from that, what I found was an interesting learning curve was deciding what orientation to print something in for best results. For example, curves. Printing curves upwards isn't too clean, but doing them from a flat angle looks great. It's kinda hard for me to describe, so hopefully the visuals do it justice. With all that out of the way, let's talk about everything I've made. Of course, the most exciting thing about the printer was being able to materialize ideas I've had in my head for a long time. Most of these designs came from my Tinkercad account and were made as far back as 2019. Yep, that's how long I've waited. For those who aren't aware, Tinkercad is a basic free 3D modeling program, and almost everything I've printed has been made here. Highly recommend it to anyone who wants to begin 3D modeling at a very basic scale. So, what did I print? Well, I started with some pre-sliced models on the USB, which included this tugboat and Buddha. From there I made a terrier body, CCT unit van body and roof, a running board, an austerity saddle tank boiler, a cab, a coach body with dussets, two flatbeds and one with four loads of paint, two prototype low loader flatbed, one finalized successful low loader flatbed, two funnels, a log car, three chassis, one brake van, a pannier tank, two salt vans, a miniature engine cabin boiler, the Antikythera, two wheels, and Grampus the submarine. Whew, that's a lot. So after printing all that, what can I say about the quality? Well, it's pretty good. Everything I've printed is solid and doesn't feel weak at all. Granted, that could just be down to the blocky nature of everything, but still, print lines are inevitable here. As usual, for those who know the drill of the post-print process, or the PPP, you'll need to give your pieces a hearty sand and filler priming for the smoothest results. But don't let this deter you. The raw quality is still quite nice. It's just not ready to go straight from the printer, which honestly I'm fine with. The extra chore helps really improve the quality of the pieces, so I'm more than happy to do it. Overall, I have to say I'm very happy with the Elegoo printer, and I'm really excited to use it with future projects, and expanding on what I can actually make instead of limiting myself. I'd like to extend a very large thank you to Elegoo for once again providing this to showcase in the video. If you're interested in picking one up for yourself, please check out the affiliate link in the description of the video. Also, at the moment, my PO box for fan mail is still open. If you'd be interested to send something along, check out the pinned comment or description down below. Don't feel obligated to send anything, but I'll try to share anything I get on the second channel. Also, while you're down there, feel free to check out my link tree, where you'll find links to my Instagram, Twitter, and Ko-Fi. Any and all support helps. But to end off, I've been Geoh, thanks for watching, have fun printing, and I'll see you next time.